Nice to see you. Obviously, Jurgen Klopp is the big story today. You saw him only a couple of days ago. What's your reaction?
Okay. It's a bit surprise for all of us. No one expected, but every moment of our lives has a start and an end. And of course, is the Jurgen's decision to be honest. Okay, long time there. It's almost 8 years, almost 500 games in managing Liverpool Football Club. And of course, it's long time, and good for him and good for Liverpool that it was with success. Of course, let's see what is going to happen. He knows really that because the relationship we have, of course, always wishing him all the best, to be honest.
And he's saying that he's running out of energy and he can't keep going and going and going. As a manager who knows all about the pressures, I mean, how do you relate to that?
Okay, and it's a feeling. Of course, now he has this feeling, and of course, it's up to him to decide, really. Of course, all of us, we know that he's really... the pressure is always behind us. You have always running. You are always running. You finish one, you are thinking the next one. You have even no time to get a good feeling from the success, because you want always to prepare the next one. And when you don't have a game that goes in the right direction that you want, you put always in pressure on you to change for the next one. Is always, you know, the moments not so good. They have a big impact. When you have very good moments, even the time to celebrate is not enough, because you want always to prepare the next one. But it's our job. I see as a privilege as well, and of course all my colleagues, I think they see in the same way. It's a privilege to have this pressure behind us. It's up to each one of us to think when is the best moment to have a small break, to think, to save some energy again, to go again.
And just finally on Jurgen, I mean, obviously you've gone up against him. What makes him such a great manager, do you think?
I think the job that he's been doing so far in his career speaks for himself. Really, the impact that he made in Bundesliga, with the great success that he had there, and of course the big change that he made since he arrived in Liverpool. It's clear that the titles that he got in the club and before he came had a long period without winning Premier League and all that stuff, and he was a massive change there, and all the credits for him. I think all his career speak for himself. Okay. As a man, very good words for him, of course, always really respectful with everybody in this and that he play against. Really nice guy, really good guy to have a football chat always, and really a good guy.
So for Fulham, it's back to the Cup, the FA Cup, after Liverpool in the Carabao. I mean, 3 days, though. I mean, how much is that going to affect you, given the fact Newcastle have had 2 weeks off?
Yes, of course, Newcastle had all the time to prepare well for this game, for sure with a small break. I don't know, but for sure with a small break after that busy period during December and January. Of course, with the break, is always... good when you can give even if it's a small break for the players, if they come and the fresh mindset to work again, and they have had all the time to prepare the game in the best way they can, for sure, with all the details that is important to prepare for a game. You are in the other side that we did play the last Wednesday, in a really important one, an emotional game for us, is what it is. And if you ask me about preparation, of course, you are going to be ready for the game. We didn't have all the time that Newcastle have had to prepare the game. But it's not going to be an excuse. You have to go to play the game as a FA Cup round should be played. And at Cottage, it's always good for us to don't travel after that game against Liverpool. And we are going to give our maximum to be in the next round.
How much did Wednesday emotionally and physically, though, take out of the team?
Took a lot from ourselves, no doubts about it. Even, of course, if you had got a different result, of course, emotionally is going to be different. Even if you are with more fatigue, when you get good results, sometimes the fatigue goes behind you, because most of the times the emotional part play a big part on it. But of course, took many things from us. But as I said before, cannot be excused if you want to be in this type of stages of competitions. If you want to go as long as you can in the competitions, after cannot be it cannot be excused that we have not enough time to prepare. But it is, of course, if you ask me if I would prefer to play on Wednesday, on Sunday instead of Saturday, and after on Wednesday instead of Tuesday, of course I would prefer. But about the schedule, it's not for me. I cannot change. Not for me to take this type of decisions. And you have to go. What you can do is to take care as better as you can from the players, to try to recover them as better as you can, and of course behind the scenes to do our maximum to be ready. Of course, now is what we are doing. To tomorrow we are going to keep assessing the players to take the best decisions for the 11.
Yeah, and on the team news, any fresh injury news or any thoughts on
that? Not fresh injury news. That is a good thing for us. Still the same about Adama Traoré, still out. And the three players that they are in the African Cup.
And Adama, when will he be back?
Nice to see him back in the pitch with his teammates, doing some small side games, all that stuff. Not ready to be involved. Let's hope more 1 or 2 weeks we can see him with full sessions with his teammates, and of course ready to help us.
And Marco, less than a week now on the transfer window, and not much is happening here right now. Is anything going to happen?
Let's see. I said probably straight away in the beginning of the window for you to stop some of the things around. Is going to be a tough moment for us to go in the market. We are trying, but it's not an easy moment for us to go. It's the feedback that I got from our board. Of course, we did prepare ourselves to go. We know what we need for the squad. Some things that we are not able to do last summer, when we lost at least one really important player for us that we sold. But it's what it is. If you cannot go, I cannot change this.
Yeah, and just on Tosin, is he showing any sign of signing a new contract? What does he want to do?
Okay, keep conversations with the club board, with his agent, and not news right now. Let's see what is going to happen in the future.
But you want to sign a striker by the end of next week?
It's not. I don't want to put just the focus in the striker. We have at least two positions that they were a target for us to reinforce our squad. Until now, it's not being possible because the reasons I already spoke about. And let's see. If you ask me if I expect many moves until the end of the market, not even if you we did plan in a different way last October, last November. That's what it is.
Thank you.
What's the mood been like of your players in the last couple of days in training?
As we expected, of course, after the match was a tough moment for us. The players, they gave everything. They gave their maximum as our obligation, but as I expected as well, and as I promised to you all that we are going to give. And they gave everything in a game that we didn't start well, in a game that we knew that we have to win. To have the chance to play the final, consider early goal is really tough against a top side like Liverpool, when you got the best chance until that moment with João in that corner. We got a little bit more time than we'd like to settle our game. It was difficult to settle after that early goal from a top side like Liverpool. But we knew that we needed a goal to come back in the game, and unfortunately for us, we just scored late in the game. Even so, the game changed completely after that moment. Of course, we had that chance with Andres Pereira, the off-the-post ball that was 55, 60 minutes, probably with more time. Everything is going to be different, is what it is. The mood in that moment was difficult. Day after, straight away, we started to prepare Newcastle. The faces, they were not the best, of course, the mood, but our obligation is to change quick the right mindset. We had good conversations with the players about it. Of course, when you arrive in this type of stages, if you don't achieve what we wanted and what was our ambition, of course, it's always tough. But the best way for us to be again in this type of stages is to do well our job in the FA Cup. And this is the reality. The season is too far to be over for us. We have so many games, so many things to fight for, and we have to change quickly right mindset and to go for the Newcastle match.
What is it you said to the players? Are you keen to use the disappointment as a motivation going forward?
Firstly, we have to use what we did in that competition as a motivation and something that we have to be proud of. That is the first thing. Even if you we didn't achieve the final. It was a great, great run in that competition for us. Really tough game. Start last August against Tottenham. And if for a end with the Liverpool in two legs, and we were really competitive, and the team to go to the final was open until the last minute, and that is a sign what we did there. That is the first thing that has to give us motivation and the confidence that we are in the right direction and we are giving our maximum and take the best from the players to be at that level. That is the first thing. About the disappointing, of course, is a normal situation, but it's a moment for us to show that it's already over. We understand why. We have to accept that Liverpool is in the final and we have to go again. If you want to have the chance to play this type of and to have this type of moments and to share this type of moments at Cottage with our fans like we did last Wednesday, where the atmosphere was a great one, we have to go again and we have to fight for the next game with the same braveness, the same attitude that we did last one.
You're up against Newcastle. They've been on a bit of a difficult run at the moment, but they've also had so many injuries playing in Europe as well. Can you sympathise with Eddie Howe for this position he's found himself in?
No, of course, the run is not the best for them. I mentioned when we played against them last December at St. James Park that even if they were not, went through in the Champions League or even to play Europa League, their group stage started really well. They had very, very good moments too. Of course, the last two games, they were not the best for them. That game in Paris that made a huge impact, in my opinion, in their run. But they started really well. They are really strong. The first moments in playing Champions League as well. And of course, in Premier League, this type of downs can happen as well. It's been tough for them the last 4 or 5 games in Premier League. But they are Newcastle. They have enough quality to change it quick. As we spoke before, they have had enough time to prepare this game, looking for all the details from the last games that they haven't achieved the good results, and we expect a really strong side.
The new owners have given the club the ability to spend hundreds of millions if they want to on transfers. How nice of a position would that be for a football manager to have that at their disposal?
Yes, and it's very good, but you have to be honest and fair with them as well. They had this chance, but they have been taking very good decisions too. And you can see the players they have been signing the last 3-4 windows. They made a huge impact in that squad. Some of them with a straight impact, like Bruno and all that players, Isaac as well, and Gordon too, and these type of players they made an impact, of course, in a very good group of players with a great fan base behind them every time. And of course, when you have this type of support, it's always a big help, but you have to do the right things, and they have been doing.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, that's the broadcast section completed. We'll move to the writers. So